Hello there, 2020 is about to end and here I am with another video, probably the last one of this year. Wish all of my subscribers and viewers a healthy new year in advance. 2020 is tough year for all of us and I feel learning about life and nature may help us in our harder days in future. In our last video, we learned about Edoconium, the green algal specimen's vegetative structures. Today, we are going to understand its reproductive structures and reproduction process. So let's learn. At first, we need to understand algal reproduction may also be by asexual and sexual methods. In the asexual methods, large multiflagellated zoospores are produced singly in the vegetative cells, which are then transformed into zoosporangia. Let's learn how this event takes place. Suppose this figure is sporangium and its whole content gradually contracts from the cell wall, forming like a pear-shaped body. At the same time, a characteristic ring of flagella is developed at one side of this pear-shaped body. We can name this body now zoospore, which is released being enclosed in a mucilaginous sheath by breaking the sporangium cell. This type of zoospore is designated as Stephanocontin zoospore. Eventually, the zoospore comes to rest, attaches itself by its colorless end and withdraws the flagella from cell wall and divides to form new filament. In our previous video, we came to know the female reproductive structure, that is Eugonium, and male reproductive structure is Antheridium. There are some species which are monoecious or homothallic, that means Eugonia and Antheridia are developed on the same plant or the same filament, better to say. Others are dioecious and heterothallic, that means reproductive structures are developed on different filaments. Depending on this distribution and structure, species of Eudogonium may be grouped as Macrandrous type and Nanandrous type. In Macrandrous type, Antheridia produced on regular size filament, whereas in Nanandrous type, Antheridia are produced on special dwarf filaments called dwarf male plants or Nanandria. At first, let's discuss about Macrandrous type of Eudogonium species, and this could be monoecious or dioecious as we already discussed. Antheridium are formed by successive transverse divisions of the vegetative cells of the filaments, resulting in the formation of a row of Antheridia. In every Antheridium, the contents divide into two and each mass develops into an anthrozoid, also known as spermatozoid. Spermatozoids are smaller than zoospore, otherwise both share similar characteristic features. Eugonium is highly differentiated structure. Each one is originating from a vegetative cell as Eugonium mother cell. This Eugonium mother cell is divided into two cells. The basal one is becoming the supporting cell of Eugonium, known as Suffultory cell, and the upper one is Eugonium proper. The Eugonium swells out, assuming round or oval in outline. The cell content contracts themselves from the wall and form a free rounded protoplasmic body with a receptive spot that is known as the ovum. Each Eugonium bears one egg and open either by the formation of a pore or by the transverse splitting of the Eugonial cell near the top corresponding to the receptive spot of the ovum, through which the swarming anthrozoids reaches the immobile egg. Sexual reproduction is oogamous. Now the male gamete penetrates the egg and fertilization takes place, and the nucleus of anthrozoid fuses with the egg nucleus and the resulting zygote is an oospore. The oospore develops a heavy wall and gradually passes into resting phase. After a period of rest, the oospore is set free either by the decay or rupturing of the Eugonial wall. Meiosis takes place in oospores and forms four haploid nuclei. the contents of each of which rounds itself off with a nucleus and becomes a zoospore. These zoospores resemble the zoospores formed in the vegetative cells, except that they are much smaller than the latter. These zoospores develop into new filaments. In Monoecious macrandus type, the new filaments are of same kind, whereas the Dioecious macrandus type, two of the zoospores produce male filaments and the other two female filaments. In Nanandrous type, the oogonia are identical with macrandrous type, while the while there is an interesting dwarf male filament or nanandrium plays a very important role. The dwarf male plants are developed from a special type of zoospores known as androspores. The androspores are produced in androsporangia, which are formed by repeated transverse divisions of the ordinary vegetative cells of the filament, and the contents of each of these androsporangia are transformed into a single zoospore and an anthrozoite. Most commonly, the androsporangia are produced from the same filament which bears the oogonia, that is gynandrosporus. More rarely, they occur on a separate filament, and that would be idioandrosporus. The androspore then liberated, swimming towards and attached with either to the oogonial wall or to the wall of the saphultory cell, and germinates to form dwarf male filament. Either antheridial mother cell develops into antheridium, which produce two anthrozoites, each bearing the characteristics of crown of apical flagella, and the anthrozoites escape by a lid-like opening of the antheridium and make their way to oogonial aperture. The act of fertilization and the formation of oospore is exactly the same as in macrandrous type. There are two interesting hypotheses we could draw here. The first one is the androspores are equivalent to smaller zoospores that are produced from the oospores by reduction division. In nanandrous type, instead of giving rise to normal filaments, it develops male dwarf filaments, while zoospores in macrandrous type develop normal filaments and no formation of dwarf male. So according to this, macrandrous type is considered as more advanced. On the other hand, the androspores are nothing but prematurely liberated antheridial mother cell, which later produce anthrozoites. According to this view, macrandrous type are more primitive. So what do you think? Please put a comment below. Let me know your perspective. This is all about today's video, learners. I personally prefer this book for algal studies. Thank you for your patience. Stay safe. Stay alive.